two writers recognized for the talent, for the humor, for the artistic skills, Tobias Smollett and Lawrence Stern. Let's start by Lawrence Stern. Lawrence Stern produced a novel called Tristram Shandy. The title of the novel is the title or the name of a character, the hero, called Tristram Shandy. Lawrence Stern in this novel tries to prove that novels shouldn't be sentimental as used to be before with the Richardson and Henry Fielding. A man should know a woman and should marry by the end. He was against such sentimentality and tries to create new themes, more provocative, more complicated and more complex as far as the relationship between characters is concerned, or the topic type is a little bit strange, odd, par rapport to the tradition of the time. So Tristram Shandy is about the birth of Tristram. We should witness the birth of Tristram, but it's full of comic, full of humor. Tristram is the baby who, once he was in the womb of his mother, he pretends, after, because Tristram is the narrator of the story, he pretends that he was listening to his mother when she was speaking to his father, once a baby. So I don't know. Anyway, I have an idea in mind after I tell it to you. So Tristram is heard for Lawrence Stern. This is an experimental novel, up to him, and for him it is proved that the baby can listen to the mother's complaints, voice, and so on. And this is, of course, scientifically proved. Well, it's not our topic. The topic is rather that when Tristram Shandy's mother got the pain for delivery, the family, of course, his father, sent for the call of the midwife who came. She comes very quickly, but as another support for her, his father calls for a doctor to come. What happens during the delivery pain of Tristram is that the doctor cuts by accident his thumb, his finger. The midwife falls down, and because of these circumstances and events went very quickly, Tristram, the baby, the poor baby, was broken his nose. The nose accidentally was broken by the doctor. The doctor directly repairs his nose by a bridge. It's the way Lawrence Stern tells the story is really, really, really humorous and comic. Anyway, writers, whenever there was a tradition to call the name of the title of the novel by the name of the character. What for? To know the character. Whenever we have, for example, Daniel Defoe, Robinson Crusoe, we know Robinson Crusoe. It is entitled Pamela, we know Pamela. It is entitled Joseph Andrews, we know Joseph Andrews. Unfortunately, there was a trick from Lawrence Stern that he entitled his novel by Tristram Shandy, but there was, readers are disappointed to know who is Tristram Shandy. We read cannot know after the delivery of his childhood, of the birth of Tristram Shandy. Then he is a narrator. He is brought up he grows up and went to France, to Europe, wandering from different regions till settling in France, where he really finds the, or cures his desire or his want for death, is no more stealing his emotion after being out of France. So the novel is made up of 9 volumes, really very, very, very long to read, very long. It was published in the year 1759 to 1767. It took him almost a decade in order to complete the huge volume of Tristram Shandy, and the safety of and security of Tristram Shandy in France is the the denouement for the novel, but parts of humor can make you or motivate you to read the novel, but to know Tristram Shandy exactly life and opinions is really, I'm really disappointed at this point, and it was purposefully made by Tristram Shandy to break the tradition, to title a name, the name of a character that you cannot know all along the novel. Then we have Tobias Smollett. I prefer Roderick Random. Roderick Random, Tobias Smollett, novel, very successful also, by which it was recognized as a pillar in the rise of the novel. Roderick is an orphan. It means Roderick is the boy out of a happy marriage between a Scottish wealthy man and with a woman who is from the low class. Of really low status of society, and of course naturally or indeed the family refuses this marriage and rejected the mother, who is from the low class, but their son insists to marry her, was pregnant and got a boy called Roderick Random, who becomes the hero of the novel. Roderick unfortunately very soon becomes an orphan because his mother after his delivery should die, and his father was lost into grief because he used to love her very much, so he abandoned the country far away and left his son for the circumstances. The grandfather, it means the father of his father, took his charge, but very barely, and not at the level of a rich, wealthy Scottish family. He sent him for studies in a free school, and there also Roderick got abuses from all most of his school masters, who used to despise him and punish him for wrongdoing that he was innocent from. After the school, during the school, and in spite of all those conditions, Roderick was a good student and he learned many languages and he was getting very deep and good knowledge. And his life really was complicated after the death of his grandfather. So he was also again sent to oblivion thanks to the support of his uncle, the brother of his mother. His mother's brother is a lieutenant in the Navy, and he takes again the charge of his nephew, Roderick. So Rory or Roderick could, thanks to the support of his uncle, reached the university, where he was a good student there. And fortunately, after his uncle went to retreat, he could no more support him, support his or pay his studies. And again, Roderick was sent to a harsh life or mode of life. And the only for him solution to save his life is to meet a rich, wealthy woman to save his support him, and indeed he thought in the beginning to meet a woman whom he falls in love, or he seems to fall in love, Miss Williams. But Miss he wanted her as a woman, before knowing that this woman is a fallen woman. She is not a correct woman, and he of course. This can't work for him, so he left. They leave each other, and while he was wandering in the Thames River, he saw a ship. He jumped. He went to that journey. The ship was going to Jamaica, and in the ship also the captain despises him so much, despises Roderick, and when he finds the Greek language in his notebook, he accuses him. The captain accused Roderick as a spy, and fortunately the ship was back to England, and Roderick was saved from any other menace. He really meets the love of his life, and Narcissa, a wealthy and good woman with whom he felt support, love, and so on. But Narcissa has a brother who of course refuses Roderick because he saw him with no money, and he refuses the marriage to give him to approve the marriage of his sister Narcissa. miraculously could Rodrigo be united, reunited or meeting his father, remember his father, after the death of his mother or his wife, went abroad. Now his father has become very wealthy and Rodrigo could at last inherit a bulk of money, an amount of money enough to marry Narcisa without the brother's approval. And finally, after a long Rodrigo's hardship in life, hopefully the denouement or the conclusion of the novel is very happy by the marriage of Rodrigo with Narcisa, without any support of the family, after being now rich and no more needing another one to help them. So these are brief summaries of the novelists. Let me give you an overview of all the novelists. We have John Bunyan by the end of the 17th century with his novel Pilgrim's Progress. Then we have the beginning of the 18th century, the year 1719, with Robinson Crusoe. Then we have the mid of the 18th century with the year 1740 with Pamela by Samuel Richardson. Then we have 2 years after 1742 with The Peer to Samuel Richardson, Henry Fielding with his novel Joseph Andrews. Then we have the years 17, back to my memory, bad memory, 1759 to 1767, then back to the year 1784 with the publication of Tobias Smollett's Roderick Random, and by the end of the century 1759 to 1767, the publication of Life and Opinions of Tristram Shandy by Lawrence Stern. These are the writers who contributed to the beginning, to the appearance, to the flourishing of the English novel in English literature. And they were, these novelists of the 18th century were a source for other writers, very well-known writers like George Eliot, like Jane Austen, like Charles Dickens. All of them copy and learned a lot from the satire, from the epic, from the picaresque, from the allegory of these writers who settled theoretically these traditions. After the novel, after Roderick Random and Tobias Smollett and Lawrence Stern's Tristram Shandy, there were many attempts to write the novel, but they weren't up to the level of a novel, and all of them were doomed to failure. That's why the wheel of the novel started to be slow, and time was occupied by another genre of poetry, by the romantic poetry, William Wordsworth, Coleridge, John Keats and Shelley. For a short period, romanticism, then starts the Victorian novel with Jane Austen, Walter Scott, Charles Dickens, George Eliot, Gaskell, and many other giant writers, whom, inshallah, next year will be studied. Thank you for your attention. I'm not aware the way you if you should proceed to these videos, but I hope that there is a space for you to put your questions in order to open, if necessary, a debate video for answering all your worries and questions. Stay home, stay safe. And meet you, inshallah, by the God's will, very soon. Thank you very much.